If you have a binary of helium stars, that is stars which don't contain hydrogen anymore but only helium, or white dwarfs if you like, then one of them will be a little bit bigger and it will become a supernova. But a helium star, a white dwarf, has only a very tiny atmosphere. So the younger star, which is still a helium star, doesn't have much density in the neighborhood of the older star, which has just become a supernova. So now this supernova, which becomes a neutron star, is not exposed to a great deal of matter around it, and it can survive. That is Gerry Brown's theory of the formation of binaries of neutron stars. There could also be a binary containing one white dwarf and one neutron star. So, while this has been accepted by van der Heuvel and other astrophysicists, and is certainly very persuasive to me, it gives about the right number of binary neutron stars in the galaxy, the right frequency of occurrence.